Hello everyone, welcome to part 3 of our productivity demo, Microsoft OneNote Basics and Beyond. This is a 6-part demo, so please come back and check out our other videos on this topic, or find other events and videos at microsoft.com/IT Showcase. And now, on to part 3.
The next item on our list that we wanted to cover is the idea of searching and tagging action items. So included in this is the ability to add some additional content. So right now, all we have are these pages and then the birthday party shopping list, right? That's the title. We don't have anything included inside each of those pages. What we need to do is we need to start adding some content in there in order for us to be able to search and tag items that need to be picked up or that are items for us to do. So in this case, on the birthday party shopping list, let's go down to cake ideas. Right here, we can talk about flavors. So we can type it out directly within the page. So let's say cake flavors, we want chocolate cake, vanilla cake, or let's add some sprinkles in there. So we can start to add in some different flavors that we want, right? So we got chocolate, vanilla, we want to make sure we have sprinkles on top. So these are items that we want to go through and reference. Or maybe this is exactly the type of cake we're looking for. In that case, what we want to do is we want to add some check marks for ourselves. How do we do that? Well, within OneNote, right on the Home tab, we have the ability to create to-do tags. So for each of these cake flavors, I'm going to highlight each one of these. So first of all, we want our cake to have chocolate cake and vanilla cake, and we also want to have sprinkles on top. Well, I can have these be to-do tags. So all I did was highlight each of those items and then click on the to-do tag. You'll see it will insert little squares right next to each of the flavors. So now, as soon as I go through and make sure that the cake has each one of those flavors, I can go through and check them off. So again, it's a nice easy way to create a checklist for us to go through and mark each of those items off. Same thing goes with food ideas, right? So we can go through and come up with food ideas. So of course, it's a birthday party, we're gonna have some pizza, popsicles maybe, why not? And we need some soda. So we can talk about some food ideas as well. Again, we have the checklist, so now we go through and we can mark those as to do. Not only can we mark them as to do, we can actually assign them to certain people too. So in this case, this is our family notebook, and most likely I'll be doing the shopping because I'm not much use for anything else. So I'm gonna be the one told to go pick up these items. In that case, my family can actually assign tasks to me specifically, not just be to do for anyone within the family. Each of these items to be picked up can be assigned directly to me. So again, on the Home tab, right next to the to-do tag, we have this tags area. You can actually create custom tags for yourself. So if I were to click on the dropdown, you'll see the basic ones that come through with OneNote. We have to-do, we have important, we have question, all this stuff. It's not really relevant for my needs, right? For my personal OneNote notebook. So in this case, I can go down to the bottom and create a customized tag. In this case, I'm going to create a customized tag and then click on New. When I do that, I can type in Brian Action. And in this case, I'm going to add in a hashtag at the very beginning of this display name. That's because when I search for them later on, I want this item to be the very first thing that pops up. So I'm gonna put in a hashtag Brian Action. I can also create certain symbols with it as well. So in this case, I want it to have a check mark so I can make sure that, did I finish that task? Yes, and I can check it off. So I'm gonna add in maybe this little star icon with the blue and check mark. I'll add in that to be part of the symbol. I can also change the highlight color. In this case, I want it to stand out really big, so I'm going to highlight it green. So now I've created this brand new action item and a tag so that I can search across all my notebooks. So I've got right here, Brian Action, and you can see by default, it goes to the very first spot. It gives me a quick link to be able to just click Control+1, and it will automatically tag items for me throughout my OneNote notebook. So I'm just going to click OK. You can see it adds it up to my top right over here in the tags. So in this case, each of these items on the shopping list is a Brian Action item. In that case, I can just click in front of pizza, click Control-1. It doesn't matter where you click within the word, you can click at the very tail end of popsicles and then hit Control 1 and you'll see that it will highlight that entire item. And the same thing for soda. Now what's really neat about this is the fact that I could mark all the shopping items that I need to get across all of my notebooks and even across multiple pages. So in this case, I need to pick up the food, but I also need to pick up that cake as well. So let's go up to the cake ideas and I'm going to highlight all the cake ideas and hit Control 1. You can see in addition to that original to-do tag, I added in a Brian action. So not only now is it a to-do, but it's also Brian's to-do as well. So again, we're marking off multiple pages, maybe down here at activities, I need to pick up some games as well. So you can see I've highlighted multiple items on multiple pages. Well, that can be kind of hard to organize and maybe go back and reference later on and say, oh, you know, I checked on activities. All I had to do was pick up that one item. Well, I neglected to check out the food ideas and the cake ideas, so I missed all those other items. In that case, within OneNote, on the Home tab again, if right next to the To-Do tag, we have Find Tags. If I click on Find Tags, all the tags within my notebook will be organized, and you can see because I added in that hashtag, that Brian action shows up right near the top. Well, that's beneficial because now I can see all of my actions in one single view. There they are. So now I can go through and say, oh, that's right, I need to go pick up the chocolate, vanilla cake, and the sprinkles. So now I can select each one of these items and then go through and mark each item off. And you can see I clicked on chocolate, it went directly to that page. If I were to click on, let's see, popsicles, it would take me to the food ideas page, and the games, it would take me to the activities page. So again, it's a lot easier to navigate across my notebook and across each of my action items by having these tags.
We're at the end of part 3. We hope you enjoyed it. Check out part 4 where Brian will walk us through how to integrate with the Office Suite. IT Showcase has events scheduled every month where you can get your questions answered live. We hope you'll join us again and bring your colleagues. You can find our schedule of upcoming events as well as on-demand videos and other content at Microsoft.com/ITShowcase. Thanks again.